So my topic is implementation of shift reduced parsing. So here in the shift reduced parsing, generally we are facing two problems. First problem is how to locate the substrings. Second problem is which production to choose in order to implement the productions. So to overcome this problem, we are going for the shift reduced parsing. So what we are doing in the shift reduced parsing? Generally on top of the stack it will start with dollar symbol. So in the shift reduced parsing, we are going to shift the symbol from the input one by one on top of the stack until we reach the starting symbol, and that starting symbol always is matched with the input symbol of dollar. So when these both the symbols are matching, then we are going to tell the stack is implemented, or we can say the grammar is accepted grammar. So for this, to do this shift reduced parsing, we are going for this four operations. So the first operation is shift. So in this shift, we are going to do whether we are going to shift the symbol next to the on top of the stack from the input symbol. Second one is we are going to reduce it. So in this reduce, we are going to handle on top of the stack whether the symbol is matching to the input symbol or not. And third one is stack. So whenever we are putting the symbol on top of the stack, one by one stack, we are going to use non-terminal symbols. Those non-terminal symbols should match with the input symbol which is having a terminal. So that is we are going to do the stack. And the next one is, fourth one is accepted. Whenever the stack is accepted with the matching input symbol, then I am going to tell it is accepted grammar. The finally, when any error it shows, so that means if you are not matching the stack, top of the stack with the input symbol, if any one of the symbols is not matching, then we are going to tell it is the error production. So for this, I am going to show you one example how we are going to do this shift reduced parsing. For example, I am going to consider this is a context-free grammar. So by using this context-free grammar, I am going to show how we are going to put it on top of the stack one by one symbol. So I am going to start initially with the input symbol where id plus id into id and dollar. So always the input symbol ends with the dollar and the stack always starts with a dollar. So here this dollar is used to indicate the stack is now empty. So what actually procedure we are going to do? We are going to shift one by one symbol on top of the stack and we are going to reduce into the concerned non-terminal symbols. So I am going to start here how we are going to do that. The first one is I am going to do which action. So there are four operations I told already. One is shift, another one is reduce, another one is accept, another one is error. So whenever the symbol is matching, I am going to tell whether it is matching to the input symbol. Otherwise, I am going to tell error. Or there is two more common actions we are going to use. One is shift, another one is reduce. So first, I am going to analyze this input, whether this input is matching with the context-free grammar. So first symbol I am going to analyze is id. So this id is matching with the input symbol e. So I am going to do the action shift. So what here I am going to do is, I am going to shift the symbol on top of the stack. So now how the stack looks initially, now consider this is a stack. The stack is now dollar, indicating it is dollar, saying that the stack is empty. Now on top of the stack, I am going to push one by one symbol and I am going to reduce it to the concerned non-terminal symbol. So first action I am going to do is shift. What I am going to do, I am going to shift this top of the input symbol to the stack. So what I am going to do, I am going to shift the symbol id. So now I have shifted one symbol on top of the stack. Now on top of the stack it is id. Now the input will become plus id star id and dollar. Okay. Next, before going to the another action, I am going to analyze the top of the stack, whether it is a terminal or it is a non-terminal. So here on top of the stack I have a non-terminal symbol. I am going to check with the context-free grammar whether this terminal symbol will match with any non-terminal symbol. Yes, it is matching with E. So what I am going to do, I am going to reduce. Here I am going to do the action which is reduce. What I am going to reduce? I am going to reduce E to ID. So this ID will be changed to now E. So what will happen? Here on top of the stack, this ID will be changed to E. So here again plus ID star ID dollar will remain. So now you consider on top of the stack what it is. Already it was ID. Now that ID is changed to E. So here on top of the stack is now E. Next, I am going to check what action I am going to do it. So I am going to shift the symbol because again E to E we cannot able to reduce it. So what I am going to do, I am going to shift the symbol. So what I am going to, which symbol I am going to shift it? Plus. So plus I am going to shift on top of the stack. So now E plus will remain here and in the input symbol it will be ID, star ID and dollar. So now what will be on the top of the stack? On top of the stack now plus will come. Okay. So next I am going to check whether I have to shift or I have to reduce it. Yes, I cannot able to reduce E plus. Instead, I am going to shift the symbol ID. Again, I am going to do the shift, which is nothing but E plus ID. Here, star ID and dollar will remains. Okay. So now, what will happen on top of the stack? Now the symbol E will be there. So finally, we have to reduce to the non-terminal symbol. Until otherwise, we are going to reduce it one by one. So the symbol, which is nothing but shift ID. So this ID will become here. So dollar E plus E star ID. Okay. So here dollar will remain same. Again, I'm going to use ID here. Again, I'm going to reduce. Now we cannot able to shift any symbols because we have reached the top of this input is dollar. So my only option is I can able to reduce this ID. So this ID I'm going to reduce to E again. So E tends to ID. So this ID will become now dollar E plus E star E. Okay, now on top of this tab, what it is? It is E already. So what I said, finally it has to reach the starting symbol of E and it will match with this dollar. So here we have so many E's. Again, I'm going to do reduce till I reach the starting symbol. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply again the action which is reduce. So what I can reduce? I can reduce E star E to, see we have three productions, E plus E, E star E or bracket E. So on top of the stack, what symbol we have now? E star E. So this three things I'm going to change. I'm reduced to what? E. So E reduced to E star E. Those three symbols will be reduced to E plus E. Okay. Now on top of the stack, what it is? We have only E plus E. Okay, again I am going to reduce to E plus E to E, E plus E to E. So this E plus E will be reduced to starting symbol E and here dollar will remain. Now what have did? I have reduced E plus E to E. Okay, so finally the answer is accepted grammar. Why it is accepted grammar? Because we have to show the starting symbol of E in the contextual grammar, which is equal to the starting symbol, ending input of the ending symbol of the dollar in the input symbol. So when these two symbols are matching, then we are going to say the grammar is accepted. Suppose if these two symbols are not matching, then we are going to say the grammar is error.